This is a story of hope and change. It is a story of a people and a place which the mainstream has neglected, where poverty, illiteracy, lack of infrastructure, and poor service delivery still remain facts of life. Getting the women to stop their work, leave their homes, and come to the meetings is one of the first challenges faced by the facilitator.
The participatory learning and action cycle works with the group. It empowers the group. It is a cycle of 10 meetings, with one meeting taking place every month. It is a very planned and systematic approach. The village women come together, sit together, share their experiences, learn from each other, and support each other. All this is initiated by the facilitators.
She meets the women in their homes. She talks to them, tries to understand their problems and their cultural practices. In this way, she learns from them and also motivates them. And thus begins the cycle of 10 meetings.
Think of Munni as an organization and Nitima as the community. What is happening here is that Munni alone is bearing the entire load and the community is not sharing any of the responsibility. Not only that, the community is totally dependent on the organization. We at Ekjut do not want to work like this. In the second pair, the organization bears the load of the community only for some time, after which it abandons the community. When such an approach is taken, sooner or later, the group disintegrates because it has no direction, no sense of what it has to do next. The third pair is walking merrily hand in hand. Both the organization and the community are together, on par. We at Ekjut want to be like that. We want to work together with the community. We want to learn from each other so that we can go the distance.
The first five of which focus on identifying and prioritizing problems related to pregnancy and childbirth.
This is our fifth meeting. In this meeting, the women have selected the problems that they think are the most crucial. They did this by playing the six pebble game. They put three pebbles against the problem which they thought was the most urgent, two pebbles against the second most urgent problem, and so on.
The meetings are held in the open. All are welcome to attend. Mothers-in-law, daughters-in-law, adolescent girls. The men may not directly participate, but they are there, watching and listening, and in this way picking up important messages. The facilitator wants the women to figure out the barriers that could arise while implementing the solutions identified in the previous meeting. She also works with them to find practical ways by which the barriers can be overcome, so that the bridge can be crossed and the women can reach the safety of good health that lies on the other side. Pebble game, bridge game, storytelling, picture cards. These are some methodologies that the facilitator uses to involve the women, to make them participate in collective problem solving. Here is another methodology. The role play is a fun way to articulate and demonstrate much of the learning that has taken place so far. That prolonged labor requires immediate hospitalization, which in turn means making arrangements for transport. All this and more is enacted in this role play. Today is the big day, the day of the 10th and final meeting. The women and the facilitators will share with the entire village and with visitors from neighboring villages what they have learned, the problems they have prioritized, and the solutions that they are confident of implementing. They will ask for help and cooperation from the entire village, from the headman, from the school teacher, from the men, from adolescents. They will demand their rights and entitlements from the government so that the entire village can begin its collective journey towards a better and healthier life.
To all of you, men, women and children who have gathered here this morning, a very warm welcome. For the past 2.5 years, the women of our village have come together, had meetings every month. We have learned to recognize the problems related to pregnancy and childbirth and how to decrease the death of newborn babies. We talk about our problems. We decide which are the most urgent ones and how to find solutions and how to get past the barriers that could arise while carrying out the solutions. We are now equipped with information.
In one village, a woman had heard in the meeting. So when it was time for her delivery and the baby was born, she immediately gave the baby her breast milk. They had talked about doing exactly this in the meeting. So she was confident that she was doing the right thing. When I see women acting so confidently, it makes me feel very nice.
Earlier, the women did not have much information. But now the women have become aware. They can solve their problems. So even if we are not there, the women would carry on. I really believe this and it makes me feel good. It makes me feel very good.
This is a story of hope and change. A story of an effective learning process that creates awareness, that privileges collective decision-making and action. Meeting as a group, month after month, has helped the women become more confident, more informed, more empowered. It is a slow dance. The women are happy to be together, happy to be alive, happy to be healthy.